welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the major differences between the ACCS Anaesthetics program and the core Anaesthetics program. If you are not aware what the ACCS program is, I have actually uploaded a very detailed video about the ACCS program, and that's not just for Anaesthetics, but also for the other specialties that offer the ACCS program. So if you are confused about what exactly is ACCS, you can go watch that video. I will link it up in the cards or down below in the description box so you can have an idea before you actually watch this video. So let's dive into the video and find out exactly what's the difference. The first difference between ACCS and core anaesthetics training is the time. So the ACCS program is 4 years long and the core anaesthetics program is 3 years long. The second difference is that you are eligible to apply directly into intensive care specialty training, which is ICM training, directly after you complete your ACCS program. While for core anaesthetics, if you do apply, you will then have to do an extra year in acute medicine, which is going to be at the level of ST6. And therefore, obviously, you'll still be completing the extra year. The third major difference is that with core anaesthetics training, you're going to be obviously have exposure into anaesthetics and all the fields that they require you to do completing. So with core anaesthetics, obviously, it's 3 years and you do not do any allied specialties. With ACCS anaesthetics, you do allied specialties. These include the emergency medicine and acute medicine. These are the only two differences. The ICU and anesthesia is also part of the core anaesthetics program. So regardless of core or ACCS, you will still do ICU, but you won't be doing emergency medicine and acute medicine in core anaesthetics, while in ACCS, you will be doing it. Obviously, because you have an extra year, you have an extra year to prepare your portfolio, you have an extra year to pass your exams, you basically have an extra year of structured training in ACCS to do whatever you want to do in that one extra year, along with getting more exposure in different specialities. But obviously in core anaesthetics, you will complete a core training program in 3 years, you will have less time to pass the FRC exam, and obviously if you want to do any other further dual training, which is besides anaesthetics, which is ICU, then you will have to go back again, which I have already explained. This is obviously the difference between the two training programs, but I want to make it clear that the training application on OREL is same. And I didn't want to say that before I actually told you the differences between the two, because when I say that, people get really, really confused. Basically, you will do the MSRA, you will take the interview, and you will get a training number, regardless of however you want to do it. This is the pathway. And at the time of ranking is where you will decide whether you can do ACCS, you want to do ACCS, or core anaesthetics. So essentially, the application for anaesthesia is one. It's a single application. There are no two applications, the ACCS pathway or the core anaesthetics pathway. Even though I have mentioned the differences in the two, the application process is same. You're going to apply same, you're going to apply in one MSRA, you're going to apply and appear in one interview. So why have they changed this? Why are there two things? A lot of people do ask this question. So basically why they've done is this, because not a lot of people want to dual train into ICU. And obviously if you do ACCS, then you will get full 6 months in ICU, which for core anaesthetics is usually divided, and you don't have to do extra ICU, extra emergency medicine, and extra acute medicine training in core anaesthetics. And for people who just want to become anaesthetists in the future, doing fellow posts for different super specialties that anaesthetics has to offer, they don't really need to do the ACCS program, right? But people who want to do ICU had to go back in and do the SHO level acute medicine posts for a year, and this was while they were ST6. So this is the reason they created these two application types or subtypes, I must say, because the application is one. And they're basically there to help you decide whether you want to train extra, you want to get extra exposure before you join into a super specialized field, or you just want to do core training and you're sorted. Same thing goes for people who do acute medicine. They also have the option of doing ACCS or IMT, which is 3 years for them, and ACCS is again 4 years. Emergency medicine, regardless of whatever ACCS you're choosing, run through or not, it's going to be 4 years and 4 years, so it's going to be like around 6 to 8 years depending on how you do your training. Bottom line is that if you're not doing GP training in the UK, the rest of your training applications, whatever you apply for, are going to range from 6 to 8 years, and that's how it is. There's no shortcut. So if you're thinking doing ACCS is going to give you an extra year, I don't want to waste an extra year, it's really fine. But it's not going to magically change or really, really impact your life. Because regardless of whatever training specialty you take besides GP training, it is going to be 6 to 8 years long. It is long, that's how it is. And if time is the only reason that you want to choose something, then obviously go for a core. Because yes, you will be having one year less to do CCT. But other things also should be taken into consideration, especially if you look at the anesthetics competition ratios and also the SG4 competition ratios and the portfolio bits and the exam. And there's a lot of stuff going on, okay? I will link down all the documents below so that you can make an informed decision. As usual, at the end of all my videos, I do say that you can ask me any question. I'm always there to help you guys. I do respond on Instagram as well. So if you feel like this video has helped you, please give the video a huge thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you have not already. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!